So to be able to do some hardware prototyping on our Bit-zee bot, we're going to put the center section of a breadboard on top of our Arduino. We need to connect it to something, so we're looking at maybe using a wine cork to put between these surface mount components here on the Arduino board. The cork is non-conductive and it's pretty easy to cut, so I figured that might be a good way to connect the board. And so we need to find the height of our power connector and our USB connector. And they happen to be the same height, so we can cut our wine cork down to the right size. And we're just trimming the rough edge off here with a hacksaw blade. And actually should be doing that on top of a scrap piece of wood, so we'll move it to there just so we don't scar up the table when we get to the bottom of it. And you can see the cut's not perfectly straight. So in order to fix that, we're gonna cut the cork just a little bit larger than we need it to be. And it's close to 2 centimeters there. And then we're gonna take the cork and file it down and get it nice and smooth. And the file will let us take off just a little bit at a time so we can get it just the exact right height. Now that we have the cork the right size, we're going to squeeze out a blob of hot glue that's about the size of a dime. And we're gonna push our cork down on the center of it. And so that way the cork is going to be able to support our breadboard. Now, when I did this, I realized that the cork was too far over and it's actually obscuring some of the numbers. It's covering over some of the numbers that I need to be able to see. So I was able to trim a little bit of it off with the break-off blade knife. And apparently cutting through the grain structure of the cork in this direction works pretty well with the knife. So in order to get it lined up just right, just trimming off the edge there to make it just a little cleaner. And then there's a little bit of hot glue left at the bottom. So to clean that off, I'm just gonna score it and then take a screwdriver and peel it up. So now we have our connection, and it looks like our breadboard will be pretty well supported. And there's a double stick tape on the back of the breadboard that's got a paper coating over the top of it. So we need to remove that paper coating or paper cover to expose the double stick tape and allow us to stick the breadboard down. So we're just removing that paper covering, and getting it, we're only removing it in the sections where we know it's gonna touch the cork, the USB connector, and the power adapter connector. And once we have that lined up, we'll just take our breadboard and press it into place. And this is going to allow us to change out different components like resistors and capacitors and transistors, and allow us to do some different configurations and experiments with the Bit-zee bot.